That, as you said, terrorism is a fight against injustice, right? I also believe that terrorism is somehow a fight against the government of by a common people. किसी इंसान के साथ अगर अन्याय होता है तभी वो जाके मजहब के नाम पे लोग इकट्ठा करता है और फिर यू नो ही ट्राइज टू फाइट अगेंस्ट वट एवर हैज हैपन टू हिम. बट वट आई बिलीव इज एक इंसान एक नॉर्मल पर्सन यू नो इफ समबड़ी हम में से अगर कोई गुजरात में होता तो शायद हम भी वही करते जो उन्होंने किया. मतलब और आप क्या कर सकते हैं, आप पुलिस पे आपको भरोसा नहीं है, जुडिशियल सिस्टम 10 साल लगा देगी. तो एक नॉर्मल इंसान के पास कौन सा ऑप्शन बचता है अगर उसके साथ कुछ बुराई हो तो. What would your advice be to a normal man like me if something like this happens to me?
Brother,
what should we do?
I agree with you. What you are saying is that if it happened with you or me, yeah, when we see our family members being killed in front of us, our mothers and our sisters being raped, our houses being, what will you do? And I agree that what you do the same thing. A normal human being will do that. That's normal. Unless you have so much faith in Almighty God. I do agree with you. 99% human beings, unless he's wearing bangles, कलाई पे चूड़ियां पहने तो अलग बात है. अदरवाइज दिस इज अ नॉर्मल रिएक्शन अनलेस अ पर्सन हैज फेथ इन ऑलमाइटी गॉड. इवन आई वुड वांट टू डू द सेम इफ आई डिड नॉट नो माय कुरान, इफ आई डिड नॉट नो फ्रॉम द कुरान इट इज रॉन्ग. बिकॉज इफ आई किल्ड द इनोसेंट ह्यूमन बीइंग आई एम बिहेविंग लाइक द सेम पर्सन हुज कॉज्ड प्रॉब्लम इनजस्टिस टू मी. जस्ट बिकॉज समवन डज इनजस्टिस टू मी इट डज नॉट जस्टिफाई मी टू किल अदर इनोसेंट ह्यूमन बीइंग. Just because somebody has robbed me, I can't go and rob a third person. If I catch that person responsible and book him and punish him, that's a different case. But I cannot kill any innocent human being. Based on the logic of the Quran, that it prohibits you from killing any innocent human being, I, because I know the Quran, I will not retire it in that way. I will try and get evidence. I will try and convince the government. If he goes scot-free, what I say, that all those people responsible for these terrorist acts, whether done in Gujarat, in Bombay riot, whether the politicians, whether the police, whether the people who have killed, whether the people who did the bomb blast, even if they go scot-free in this world, on the day of judgment, God will surely punish them. So we as Muslims believe, as it's mentioned in the Quran, in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 185, that kullu nafsin zaiqatul maut, every soul shall have a taste of death. But the final recompense on the day of judgment, because we believe this life is a test for the hereafter, we leave it. If we cannot do something here, we leave it for Almighty God to do the justice. And inshallah, he'll be punished in the hereafter. If we catch Hitler today, what punishment can you give him? 6 million people are innocent, what punishment can you give him? You can kill him once. What about the remaining 5,999,999 people? Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 56, that those who reject our signs, we shall put them in the hellfires. And as often as the skins are roasted, we shall give them fresh skin so that they shall feel the pain. Today, science tells us that there are pain receptors. So God tells that on the day of judgment, if their skins are roasted, we shall give them fresh skin so that they shall feel the pain. If God wants to incinerate Hitler 6 million times, you can do it. We can't do it here. So therefore, we leave it to the main justice to God.